If you're going to do an installation on board, then you're going to look for batteries that fit, that have been shaped to fit inside that engine. And that's what this represents here. We have just different shapes. This shape happens to fit into a Shea and a Climax tender. It was to fit right into the corners. This battery competes with this battery for physical size and performance. And then we have just flat packs. So again, it just gives you a variety to put these inside your tender. All right. Now, characteristics of batteries. Okay.
Are those all the same kind of batteries?
Okay. The question is, are all these the same kind of batteries? This one's the lithium. The other ones are all nickel metal hydride. So these are the nickel metal hydride type batteries. And no, NiCads are still being used. John brought me some NiCads yesterday to finish his installation. See, NiCads are pretty inexpensive now. You can get them at Walmart. You can go to your favorite radio control store, Radio Shack, and they come in, you know, that little long pack, and they have a plug on them. So there's adapters to plug into all this stuff. So that's a very convenient way to do it. What I'm showing here is the higher end, the more expensive batteries. All right. Why? Because they're shaped to fit into the loco. I have to pay to have somebody make those. They just don't come that way. All right. They also are higher powered. All right. Now let's talk about runtime for batteries. All right. Right now, the lithium ion and the nickel metal, I think for the price, give us the best runtime. Now, what does that mean? Does that mean an hour, 2 hours, or does it mean 9 hours? All right, there's variables here for doing all that, but to keep it general, a battery about this size is a 2 hour runtime. All right, a battery this size is like a 4 hour, and this will go up to 9 hours. That's in there. So one of the things you have to ask yourself is, how long do I want to run my train for? If I only want to run for an hour, you might be able to go to Radio Shack and buy NiCad batteries and just use those. But if you want to run for 2-3 hours, if you want to run for 6 hours, then you're going to want to talk about maybe the more powerful batteries that are out there. There we go. Now charging these batteries, okay, what you have to anticipate is that the charger, all right, it's called a smart charger, all right? And what that does is it slowly charges the battery, because you don't want the batteries to get real hot, and they could actually boil them, which would then ruin the batteries. So you pick a charger, a smart charger, that is appropriate to that battery, all right? And again, if you want to get technical about it, I can get into that level. But again, whoever sells you the batteries, they probably have in mind a charger that is appropriate so that you don't overcharge them. And sort of a rule of thumb here is that if this is a 4-amp battery, you want to charge it at half of its capacity so that it comes up in a nice gradual way. All right, now, is anybody in here fly airplanes? Do a model, or say, okay. You guys sometimes are crazy, because what I'll see you do is take dry ice, take your batteries, charge them in 15 minutes, and then back flying, all right? So what they're doing is they're jam charging these batteries because they want to start flying again, all right? Well, you better have dry ice, and you better have some other considerations to do that. So I don't recommend, we don't have to do that for our trains. because we don't, you know, fly at 20 miles an hour and have to go up and down, you know, we can put our batteries in their trains, and we can run for 2-3 hours, and the battery discharges in a nice, evenly fashion, and then you can go charge it again. One of the questions is, how often can I charge? John, on the lithiums, because I don't use them that much, can you charge these all the time? In other words, if you run it for an hour, can you just charge it again?
Sure.
Okay.
Leave
all right.
And with the lithiums, if you run those, like you mentioned, they've got a circuit board in them, because they don't want that battery doesn't like to be taken below a certain level of charge. Part of that circuit board in there will not allow that battery to be discharged below a certain level. Like you said,
got the little battery charger.
Okay. If you run that battery to the point where all the motors are running, and the battery might get a little warm, their charger, if they sell it that, it takes 4 hours to bring that battery back up to full charge.
Okay.
But once it gets to full charge, the circuit board in here causes it to go in what people call fuel. So you put the power into the battery so you don't overcharge. So when I do my lithiums, I'll plug them in at night and I just forget about it. Some people say you can send them to a fire extinguisher at 9/11. I've been using these since they collapsed.
Okay.
The other thing that comes out is how many cycles you can get before the battery goes south on it. I haven't kept track. I'll say easy 150. 150 cycles. You can run that 150 times, completely down, recharge.
Yep. All right. What John was talking about, and Al, we're going back and forth, is that on this particular battery, all right, when the battery goes down, you can go ahead and recharge it. All right, you don't need to wait, for a certain period of time. If it slows down, you can go ahead and recharge them, and you can do that with nickel metal too. All right, so that's the same. Don't want to confuse anybody. And then another part of their discussion is how many charge cycles or how many times can you recharge these batteries? All right, and the manufacturer has a specification. These guys use them all the time. They're getting 150 recharges, which has been how many years? Okay. All right. All right. So that's another question: is that if how long will this battery last? And these gentlemen have been using these, and they're getting 3 years so far. I've been selling some of these batteries. I had a customer show up yesterday, and it had 04. Every battery I sell has a date on it, so we know when they were made. And it ran for 4 years, all right? But they use it on a regular basis. So these batteries should last a good long time. The key is the charger, all right?